see. So, thank you for the introduction, and I want to thank Ahmed Abbes for the invitation and for this organization of this conference. So, so today I will talk on character cycle. So let me fix some notation. So, small k will be algebraically closed. Field of characters P. Assume this is positive. And X will be smooth of dimension D. So this will be my variety. And as a quotient, I take lambda. Lambda will be, so this will be a finite field of a characteristic L divided from P. And K, so I want to write script K, so it will be like this. So this will be a constructive complex of lambda modulus on the ℓ side of X. So for such object, we want to define the character cycle. Yes, yes, yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So you want something like what is noted usually as DBC.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah. So character cycle, so this should be this will be a linear combination of closed conic subset of the cotangent band. So this is a vector band associated to omega 1. So I take notation defined from ℓ-adic. So this is a linear combination of dimension D.
What coefficient?
So it will be actually a coefficient will be G1 over P. Yeah. And this conic means this is stable, closed under. Multiplication. So we want to define such object and want to study property of this object. Sorry?
Are they in general they are Lagrangian or not?
No, no. Can you see them?
No.
No. Like this? Okay, so on this object, Durinia, he wrote a note on Euler Poincaré. So this is written on. So he writes like this. So I think this is August 2nd. So and there's a famous letter to Luke. So letter. So he wrote a famous letter to Eugene. So this is dated in on. So this is written like this. But at that time he was living in France, so it must, this must be November 4th. So this note is much more detailed than this letter. But so it is already 3 years ago, but it took me 3 years to understand what he wrote. So I want to, so in this note, he states some propositions. And also conjectures. But under some assumption, so he states some proposition and conjecture on this characteristic cycle in this notes. So the goal today is that today and tomorrow, so I want to tell you what and how I can prove. But still, I need some assumption, assuming the existence of singular support. So this is, so I will explain more in detail. So in any case, this is union of finite many union of closed conic subsets of the cotangent band. So satisfying some local acyclic condition. For family of morphisms to curves or to surfaces. So this may be the goal of my series of lectures today and tomorrow. So more precisely, so this proportions and conjectures includes Milnor formula. So this is a formula for the total dimension. Of the space of nearby cycles or vanishing cycles. And also Euler-Poincaré formula. Or index formula. So this is for the Euler number. So actually this will be the characterization of the character cycle. And this is the formula we want to prove. So in this sense, this is basically conditional because we need to assume the existence of singular support. But in some case, we can get unconditional result because we have ramification theory. So ramification theory provides that we have existence of singular support, which we need to assume. But we actually have such singular support if we remove outside closed subset of codimension 2, at least codimension 2. And if our variety is a surface, we can do better. So it's existence of singular support on surfaces without any assumption. So this is unconditional. And in particular, we can get to a formula for Euler-Pankai. So we get this Euler-Pankai formula on surfaces unconditionally. So this, so this is gives a generalization of result of Lohmann. Where he makes some assumption on non-fierceness of the assumption. and actually, I was working on this problem when I was a student, but it was too difficult for me at that time. But now I'm happy to do something on this. Okay, so this is roughly the plan what I'm going to do. So let me give some table of content. So the plan is, so first I want to define what I will make it to precise what I mean by singular support. And character cycle. So this is the first part. And then I want to explain how we can construct over character cycle. And finally, I want to tell you what property we can prove. So I'm given 3 hours, so basically I spend one hour for each. Then this is my plan. Okay. So now I start the first part. So the first part is singular support. And this is characterized by the local cyclicity. Okay, so I need to give some definition. So X will be as before, so X will be smooth of dimension D. And I prepare some terminology on finite family. Of conic closed subset of the cotangent bundle. And so it will be over dimension D in the middle dimension. So the first definition. So we say, so we study, first we study morphism to curve. So F will be So this is a flat motion. Over K to C is a smooth curve. Okay, we say such a monism is is non-characteristic. With respect to this family. So we look at the So we have a canonical map from the pullback of the cotangent bundle of C to that of X. The inverse image thank you. The inverse image of S is a subset of the zero section. So this is the definition of non-characteristic. if So I need one more condition. So the intersection, so Ti will be the intersection with the zero section. So this is the notation for the zero section in the of the cotangent bundle. So for each SI, so we take we have an intersection like this. And this is a subset, so we regard this as a subset of X, and so is flat over C for every I. So this is a non-characteristic condition. So in the case if K is the zero extension of some smooth sheaf on the complement of divisor, then Ti tend to be the irreducible. Ti can be one of the irreducible component of the divisor on the boundary, and I want that the ramification. There's no vertical ramification, so this is basically such condition. So this is the condition for one curve, but actually I want to work with a family of morphisms. So that now in the second part, I assume I want to work with relative version. So I work with this commutative diagram. So this is a commutative diagram. Of flat motions. Of smooth schemes. Over K. So here, so I call this map F. So this B is the base space. So this is parameter. This B plays the role of parameter space. So this is a base scheme, so I call this B. And here, so this is a curve, a family of curves. So this is smooth of relative dimension one. And the map here is eta. So we take this eta neighborhood, but basically, so this is a family of morphism parameterized by B from X to this curve. So this is what I mean, a family of morphism to curves. So now we say, so this F is non-characteristic if for every closed point, the fiber the morphism on the fiber this is non-characteristic with F2 pullback of so we consider this condition in family. So this is a non-characteristic. Okay. Yeah. Now we can define what I mean by singular support. So KB as before. So then, then we say. So S will be, well, this will be also as before, so this is a finite family of conic closed subset of. Sorry?
The SI are not necessarily irreducible.
Yeah, actually they will be irreducible.
But when you take your definition, I wonder about the following. So you assume that the intersection of SI with the zero section is flat over C. And depends on the choice. So if you have something which is, if you have a union of things which are not irreducible, you know, the composite irreducible component, it's not clear that this condition is the same when you take the reducible component or when you take...
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Also, when you pass to eta localization, the irreducible components, something which was irreducible can become, can have several branches. So now, so in your definition, you definitely, you want to fix a particular choice of index family SI, or does it depend in some way only on the union?
Yeah, yeah. So so on the level of X, I fixed, so it will be irreducible component. But after pullback, I just keep same index. Yeah, okay. So, fine. Yeah. So now I state the condition. Yeah. So we call such family is a singular support of this k if it satisfies the condition I call SS1. I put 1 here because here we study map to curve, and we will get SS2 in lecture later. So for a commutative diagram as above, I mean the commutative diagram in this two, so family of most smooth curve. we ask that if so this motion on the top is universally locally acyclic. Relatively to the pullback, over my k. So W is a scheme of eta scheme of x cos b. So by first projection, we can still go to we can go further to x, and we can put it back k to W. And we and this condition says that this motion is universally locally acyclic with respect to this pullback I wanted to say this is non-characteristic over B. If this motion is non-characteristic over V, I forgot to write this over V after second condition there. Maybe I better start it. So we require that the non-characteristic motion is universally locally acyclic. So this is the condition required for singular support. So in the absolute case, so we just have a flat motion to curve, and we ask that there's a non-trivial vanishing cycle. So this is basically the condition, but we work in family. Okay, so we still have, so there's some elementary properties on this. So first remark is that so SSK, so this will be a notation for singular support of K. But first remark is that this is not uniquely determined. So if you add something extra, this condition is still preserved. So I write like this, but this is not uniquely determined by K. And I'm sorry?
What did you say about it being non-uniquely determined?
Yeah, because if we add something extra here, then the condition gets this condition gets stronger. So this condition remains valid.
If you add what did you say?
To S, you add, so if your S is already singular support, and if you add something extra, then you still the new one is still singular support. Yeah. Okay. And so this compatible with the construction is compatible with smooth pullback. And also finite, so and push forward by finite unified motion. So this statement is not totally trivial, but I skip it. This here. Sorry?
Is it the case that the singular support is the minimal family of irreducible subsets satisfying this, or?
You can do, yeah, you can make it like this, but yeah, I will not stick to this point there, here. Is that okay? Yeah, so I give some elementary example. So the first example is that we have this, our complex K, and suppose we have finite closed subset. So Z consists of finite many closed points, and such that on the complement, the cohomology sheaves are locally constant. So in this case, we can take as a singular support, we can just take the union of zero section. So this is the zero section. And the fibers at X. At Z. So this is a consequence of local cyclicity. Of smoothness. So this is an elementary example. And a more interesting construction is by ramification theory. So ramification theory tells us that there exists some closed subset of codimension 2. Codimension at least 2. Such that if you remove this Z, we have so ramification theory provides singular support, but today I will not give you how I will not say how we can construct singular support in this case. So, in the case where X is surface, so this means that we are left with only finite many closed points. So by the same construction here. So this gives the existence of singular support if F dimension is 2. So in this sense, ramification theory provides us unconditional result. Okay, so this is the definition of singular support. So now I got the character cycle.
No, but you need to make it non-trivial, because if you take the subsets to be too large, do you want them to be of certain dimension?
Dimension D, yeah.
Yeah,
definitions is also that middle dimension, yes.
Yeah. Yes, so they are middle dimension, yes.
No, but this is, you didn't put in the definition.
Definition one.
Ah, yeah, yeah, yes, yeah, ah, yeah. So yes, sorry, yes, please put the dimension D, yes. Yeah. Yeah, better to put it there. Yeah, thank you. Okay. So now, we are going to assume that we have a singular support. Then the problem is how to problem in the definition of a character cycle. We just need to determine the coefficient. So the coefficient will be uniquely determined by requiring such a Milnor formula. So. So I will tell you what formula we are going to study. Okay, so let me make one more definition. So Milnor formula is a formula for isolated characterized points. So I'm going to define what is an isolated characterized point. So x will be as before, and so this is a flat motion. And not in the case where yeah. So this is a flat motion. Yes. So this is a motion over K to a smooth curve. Okay. So under U, so this is a closed point. So we say we assume that we are given k and also s equal ssk. So we say I say that this is not unique, but we are going to fix it. So we say they are fixed. We say U is isolated. Characterized point if there exists a neighborhood U such that the restriction of F to the complement here to, so this motion is non-characteristic. with respect to the restriction. Of my thinking support. Yeah, so we assume that there is so locally at U, so U is the isolated point, and outside U, our motion is non-characteristic. So this is my terminology for isolated characteristic point. So, and this S is our singular support. Okay, so to state this Milnor formula, I want to define a certain intersection number. So now we take omega, so this is a basis of tangent band below at the image of our point U. Then, by this pullback, this defines, so F star of omega defines a section of tangent band on U. And by this condition, the intersection of so by this condition, the intersection, so this intersection the intersection is isolated. So this in the inverse image. Here. So this means that we can define the intersection number in this cotangent bundle on the fiber at U. So we can define this intersection number. But our assumption that SI, so this cross subset are conic, so this is independent of the choice of such basis. So by changing, so by abuse of notation, we define it like this. So. So now we are ready to prove, to state the theorem. So assume a singular support exists. Then they exist. Unique Z1 over P linear combination. which we denote like this. So this is the sum like this. such that. So this should satisfy our Milnor formula. So the minus of the total dimension of the space of, so I will tell you more like what this means. So k f so this will be equal to that the intersection number like this. So the right hand side is defined by this remark. Here.
So here you assume that Si are reducible, yes?
Yeah. And here, if for every f defined on ethyl neighborhood V of U such that U is an isolated character point. So this is a point of f. So we look at every map to a curve C defined on ethyl neighborhood of V, ethyl neighborhood V of U, such that U is an isolated point, character point. And we require that this formula holds. So we call this formula Milnor formula. And and this uniquely characterizes the character cycle, and the claim is that so they actually they exist such linear combination. And I put the star because we assume the existence of singular support. So in this to indicate that this is a conditional result. So. Let me briefly explain the notation there. So C U K five. Yeah. So this is the stalker to U of the complex of vanishing cycle. So, but. So each cohomology so this is the Galois representation of the local field at the image. So this is a local field of our curve C at the image. So this is a classical local field. So the decision field is algebraically closed by our assumption. So we have such a Galois representation and so by finiteness of vanishing circles, so we have finitely many finite dimensional vector space with such a Galois action. So we can define the total dimension is just the dimension plus Swan conductor. So for each cohomology, we can take the dimension and the Swan conductor because we have this Galois representation of classical local field. And but this is a complex, so we just take the alternating sum. So this is the left hand side, and we require this Milnor formula for character cycle.
So if the singular support exists, it exists after pullback by ethyl things.
Yeah.
So in some sense, you could have just stated your theorem just for x itself.
Yeah, yeah, that's possible.
So
yeah.
The SIs will can split after, so it's yeah. A little bit a mixture between them.
Yeah.
So if you state it just for x, it's slightly weaker?
I think it's because equivalent. But in any case, it's characterized uniquely, so it doesn't matter so much. Okay. Yeah, so I give some example. yes, so I have to explain why I call this Milnor formula. So so there's one expose in SGA7. Expose 16. So Drini proves a formula in geometric case. So this is a case where k is just a constant, and in this case, this character cycle is nothing but minus one to dimension d over the times the zero section. So in this sense, this formula is the generation of classical Milnor formula. Now I give some example. The first example is a time case. So this is U is a complement of divisor with a simple number cosine. And they are irreducible component. And let's take k to be just zero extension, and f is a smooth sheaf on U, which is time ramified along D. So in this elementary case, so and in this case, singular support is computed by Luke in this appendix to term the finitude in SGA 4.5. So this gives us an unconditional result. So in this case, character cycle. It looks similar, but a little bit is a little more complicated. So here, sum is taken over I. So here, xi is the intersection. So this capital I runs so maybe I make it more precise. Every finite, every subset and this denotes the intersection, and this is the notation for the conormal bundle. So this is more or less a well-known formula, but our character cycle is characterized by this Milnor formula, so we need to check Milnor formula. And this is actually done recently by my Chinese student. So I wanted this Milnor formula in this case is checked by in the Yang. And he almost completed writing, but not completed yet. So where I put the okay. Yeah, second example is even more classical. I'm sorry?
Cannot be reduced to the one rank one case or
Yes. Yeah, we can reduce to rank one case. Mm, but still we have to work a little bit. Okay. The second example is the case where x is a dimension x is a curve. Then in this case, character cycle is minus. So first we have first we have rank times zero section. okay. So I need to introduce z. So z is as before. So this h, the cohomology sheaves are locally constant. Then, so we have finitely many closed points, and I need to put arcing contactor there. So in this case, we just have two cases. So this is zero section and fiber. And this is also F, this is K. So this arcing conductor is rank of K minus dimension of stoke at K plus this one conductor of K.
It's integer, yeah?
Yeah, it's a Hausdorff cell. Yeah. Okay, so, yeah, and in this case, this Milnor formula is classical. Induction formula. For conductor. Okay, so that's it for part one. So, yeah, so thank you.
Any questions?
Yeah. Actually, you will show examples when where this simple support is not Lagrangian, so eight are not integer.
Up to here, no problem. But if you go higher dimension, so there's an example of non-Lagrangian case in dimension two. But we expect to have integer anyway.
So do you have cases where the coefficients are not integers?
Yeah. No, we can expect that the coefficients are always integer.
So in the tame case, your theorem also applies, because in the tame case, the singular support exists.
Yes.
So in some sense, what is more precise here is the precise description of the characteristic.
Exactly. Yeah. So we need to determine this question. This.
So is it the case that in some sense, if you have a compatible family of ℓ-adic sheaves, the characteristic cycles or the singular support don't depend? So.
Yeah. As long as ramification theory works, then we can say that. But out of that, I have no control, so I don't know.
I have a question about your definition of a non-characteristic because you ask that the map F to the curve should be flat on each T sub I. Okay. So how can T sub I can be a closed point, for instance? Can it be a closed point?
It's excluded. But so the Milnor formula is for isolated characteristic points. So in this case, so we can also include this. Because so in the definition of isolated characteristic point, we remove this point. We ask no characteristic outside this point. Yeah. So isolated TI that will never fit in the definition of non-characteristic. But it's always isolated characteristic point.
In some sense, the condition is not in the characteristic case, the Milnor formula is true. But here we go a little bit beyond the characteristic. So assume we have an isolated non-characteristic point. So if you have an isolated point, you can just remove it. It includes it.
So non-characteristic case, the both sides are zero.
But you said that, for instance, on a curve, the singular support could be the zero section union.
Yeah.
But as soon as you put closed points, I mean, fibers of closed points, then you have no map which is non-characteristic. So.
Yeah. Before you remove that point, yes.
Why the sign in the minus sign in the minus formula?
So we are working on curves.
Yes.
Yeah, so we cover the dimension one, and you put this one on the shoulder of minus one, then you get to minus one.
But on the Russian side, you get the Milnor number or minus the usual Milnor number?
No, just the intersection number.
But is it the classical Milnor number, the length of the quotient of all divided by the partials?
Yeah.
But there's but you put also a minus one, not just a minus one to the V. There was a minus one. Can you write?
Yeah. I think it's consistent. Yeah.
If you have a family of smooth varieties, let us say over a smooth family with over a smooth base, and you have a sheaf on the total space, so you can consider its characteristic cycle or singular support on the total space and on various fibers. So you is it true that it is compatible on a dense open set of the base? It's compatible in some sense with restriction to fibers or.
If we are most with non-characteristic, then it's like that. I think you need some assumption.
So I was thinking about the case of the generic point. So you have a map.
Yeah, if the
algebraic closure of the generic point, you have a new variety of an algebraically closed field.
Well, yes. On the generic, even on the generic fiber, you need some assumption.
Okay, so no other question? So we start at 11:45.
Thank you.